Well, they are ready for round two. The thrill-seeking Sea-Doo enthusiasts are heading back into the Pacific again. They're going to take off in just a couple days.
And record the whole thing. KCRA3's Mike TeSelle suited up and hit the water at Folsom Lake this morning to get an experience of the challenge these adventurers are about to embark on.
You are looking at the final preparations for an expeditionary challenge that its leader says includes the very real risk of death.
This is as dangerous as it gets.
Nearly a year after attempting an Alaska to Russia crossing on nothing more than personal watercrafts, the same Sacramento-led team is setting its sights on an even bigger challenge.
No one has ever done what we're doing before, period.
All total, this time, this trip, the goal is over 6,000 miles, all on Sea-Doo.
We'll be out for 65 days this time around.
What makes this latest Bering Sea attempt risky is not only the 37-degree Arctic water and the 15 to 50-foot waves, but also what they may encounter each night when this team camps on land.
I'm a little nervous about the bears, to be honest.
This team pulls out of Sacramento, headed to Anchorage, Alaska, on land this Sunday morning. They officially set out on the water for this record-breaking Alaska to Russia to Taiwan attempt on July 1st.
How far are we going to make it?
The million-dollar question.
It is the million-dollar question.
Out on Folsom Lake, I'd like to sell KCRA3 reports.
That looked like a lot of fun to report today. Well, Stephen Mull, the expedition leader, still negotiating for American TV rights for their Dangerous Waters program.
But he says National Geographic has already agreed to air their latest adventure on international vision. And I just can't imagine just bump, bump, bump for that far, you know? I mean, 6,000 miles or something that they've done. So
even when they take their breaks, it's not very comfortable. Like, you don't have a lot of stuff with you.